Good morning, everyone. We're so excited that you've joined us here at the Water's Edge. And if you're online with us today, you can check us out on Facebook or YouTube and feel free to like, share, and comment. And if you're live with us, here's a few things we'd like you to know. We have nursery and kids church available right across in the lobby. Also, we're always in need of volunteers. So if you want to get plugged in, you can email us at watersedgevolunteer@gmail.com or you can text your contact info to 337-352-2443. And remember, if you know anyone that's struggling, please invite them to church or share our online content with them, because this is a place where broken people belong and everyone is welcome. We have a full experience for you guys this morning, so get ready to worship with the Water's Edge Band and receive a message from Pastor Tony.
Uh-huh. you can do, oh God of wonders, your power has no end. The things you've done before, in greater measure, you will do again. 'Cause there's no prison wall you can't break through, and you can move, oh, things are possible. And there's no broken body you can't raise, no soul that you can't save, oh, things are possible. The darkest night, you can light it up.
Come awaken your people. Come awaken the city. What's up, everyone? Good morning and welcome to our Water's Edge online Sunday morning worship experience. Once again, thank you so very much for hanging out with us today. For those of you that continue to tune in and like and share these online digital messages with your friends and family, thank you so very much for doing that. We have people that are tuning in from all over the place. Continue to do that. Also, for those of you that continue to worship with us, thank you so much by worshiping with us through your generosity. For those of you that continue to give, thank you so much for that. For those of you that are just now starting to meet our $10 challenge, thank you so very much for doing that. It helps us love more people, help more people, feed more people, and serve more people. Our next food pantry is going to be right around the end of February, and your generosity in worshiping with us in that way will help us feed about 2,000 people on that day. So thank you so, so very much for that. Today we continue with our current series entitled The Elephant Room. And in this series, this is what we've been doing. We've been taking a subject that most people, especially most churches, normally don't talk about it. And in this series, instead of avoiding it, we talk about it. And so today, again, we're going to talk about something uncomfortable. But like we always do, we want to turn it around into something encouraging because God is love. Today we move on with part four. Now, as we continue today, we continue with an elephant room type of issue, an elephant room type of subject that's just true for life in general. We try to avoid this in life in general. This causes us heartache and pain and struggle and adversity in this life for life in general. And so really, this is about all of us and about what so many people go through and so many people have a hard time talking about it. My dad would always tell me, he would always tell my friends, he would always tell my brothers one simple statement all the time. He would say, he even wrote this in my graduation card, and this is what it is, and remember this today. He would say, don't live irresponsible, because there will come a day when life isn't easy, and you want to be prepared. My dad passed away around 3 years ago, and so every year since then, around the holiday time, sometimes my memories just become like waterfalls of emotions. And this, over the past few weeks, as the holiday season was coming to an end, I was thinking about my dad, and I was thinking about that statement that he wrote in my graduation card, and that one statement also stuck out to me. There will come a day. Be prepared. Be ready, because there will come a day. In different areas of your life, there will come a day. So be prepared, or at least try to be, or at least get to a place in your life where you settle in your heart that there will come a day. Notice the text, Proverbs 16:3. If you're still with me, say I'm still with you. Commit your actions to the Lord and your plans will succeed. In order to succeed, you need commitment. You need preparation to be ready. Luke 14:28. But you don't begin until you first count the cost. For who would begin construction of a building without first calculating the cost to see if there's enough money to finish it? Commitment, preparation to be ready. Proverbs 21:5. Good planning and hard work lead to prosperity, but hasty shortcuts lead to poverty. Commitment, preparation to be ready. Ephesians 2:10, for we are God's masterpiece. He has created us anew in Christ Jesus so we can do the good things He planned for us a long time ago. Commitment, preparation to be ready for the life that God is pulling us into and calling us to live. Psalms 90, verse 12, teach us to realize how short life is, or the brevity of life, so that we may grow in wisdom, or so that we may make wise choices. Again, commitment, preparation to be ready. And so again, in different areas of my life and in different areas of your life, there will come a day. So be prepared, or at least try to be prepared, or at least get to this place in your life where you settle in your heart that one day there will come a day. But right now specifically, what do we mean by that? And why would the fact that there will come a day be like an elephant room type of subject for us to avoid and then finally discuss? Why would that fact be uncomfortable for us to deal with today? Because let's be honest, some of you know what I'm talking about. And if most of you think about it really deeply, probably almost all of you know what I'm talking about. The reality that there will come a day. Back to the text one more time. Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 through 27. If you're still with me, say I'm still with you. Anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise, like a person who builds a house on solid rock. Though the rain comes in torrents, and the floodwaters rise, and the wind beats against that house, it will not collapse because it's built on solid bedrock. But anyone who hears my teaching and does not obey it is foolish, like a person who builds a house on sand. When the rain and the floods come and the wind beat against that house, it's going to collapse with a mighty crash. Be ready, because there will come a day when the waters rise. Be ready, because there will come a day when the winds beat against your life. Be ready, because there will come a day when the storms rage. There will come a day. And there's been days like that for me in my life, just like there's been days like that for you in your life. There was a day when the doctors told me that I would never be able to have kids, have children. But then there came a day when I was able to have my son Jagger through in vitro. Days of peace, days of storms. There was a day when the doctors told me that I was completely healthy. And then there was a day when the doctors told me and they diagnosed me with an incurable disease, an autoimmune disease. Days of peace, days of storms. There was a day when my father was alive and I could talk to him when I needed wisdom and advice. And then there was that day when we lost him. Days of peace, days of pain. There was a day when I felt loved and safe. And then there was a day when I felt hurt and broken and confused and unsafe and scared. Days of pain. Days of peace. There was a day when I had not lived through a worldwide pandemic and shutdown and then two major category storms a month apart from each other. And then there was a day when I did. Days of peace, days of storms. And when did you realize how true that was for your life? That there will come a day. We know that pain, don't we? We know the pain of there will come a day. There will come a day when you lose that person. There may come a day when you lose that childhood home. There may come a day when the best memories you have are of people that are no longer here. There may come a day when your job relocates you to a new city or your job lays you off because they don't have the money to pay you anymore. There may come a day when you and them stop talking forever because you cannot find resolution. There may come a day when how lonely you are makes your insides ache in your soul. There may come a day when your child is bullied and you don't know what to do. There may come a day when your child is addicted and you don't know what to do. There may come a day when someone that you love very much sits you down and they tell you that they don't love you the same way anymore, that they have changed their mind and you don't know what to do. There may come a day when you have to have that surgery that scares you to death. There may come a day when you have to have that conversation that scares you to death. And it may scare them to death too. There may come a day when you have to sit your kids down and tell them the bad news again. There may come a day when you have to pick out someone's tombstone that you love and then write their obituary. There may come a day when those people stop returning your phone calls and you don't know why. Or someone in your family becomes your greatest enemy. Or your spouse gets sick and you have to become their caretaker. Or there may come a day when you get really sick and they have to become your caretaker. There may come a day when you get falsely accused. There may come a day when you get lied about and gossiped about. There may come a day when you finally realize that you need mental help and emotional help because you're having such a hard time making sense of life right now. There may come a day when you make a big mistake and you wish you could take it all back. You wish you could press rewind and just erase it and undo it, but you can't. And now you have to try to fix it or pick up the pieces. Or there may come a day when someone else in your life makes a big mistake and it hurts your heart, and you have to pick up the pieces. There may come a day when your greatest fear, whatever it may be, comes true. Again, I think we all know the painful reality that there may come a day. Days of pain. And most of this seems like, if we're honest, you and I can't get ready for it and we cannot get prepared for it. You just kind of take it as you comes and hope you can stand back up again when it's over. But what is it that's really going on when we do this? This is what we're really doing. And remember this today, if you're still with me, say I'm still with you. We learn how to fake it until we make it. And we get good at that, don't we? Faking it. We fake it at home. We wear our mask at home. We wear our mask at work. We wear our mask at church. We wear our mask around our friends and our family and around our neighbors because we have this storm raging on the inside of us, in our mind and in our emotions. But because we don't know how to talk about it or who to talk about it to, it's become this elephant in the room. We bury it over and over and over again. And this is what it is. It's the fact that there has come a day and I'm not okay. I don't know how to deal with it. Be prepared, because there will come a day. But how do you prepare yourself for storms like this? How do you prepare your heart for something that will probably devastate your heart? Let me ask that again. How do you prepare your heart for something that'll probably devastate your heart? I guess we should explain it with a question. And this is what the question is. And notice this today. If you're still with me, say, I'm still with you. What's the one thing that you could have in your life that would help your mind and your emotions and your soul recover when you do have those days that change everything? Understand this, there is nothing that you can have in your life that will help you avoid those days and avoid those storms. That's not the preparation that we're talking about. And there's also nothing that you can have in your life to make sure that those storms don't devastate you and those storms don't crush you. That's not the preparation that we're talking about. No, God is love and God understands that we're living a very real life. What we're talking about is this. We have to answer this question and notice this today. What's going to help your mental health and your emotional health and your soul recover once those devastating storms are over? And this is the one thing that we need. This is the one thing I think that's going to make sense to you. And notice this today. Remember this. What we need is a stronger foundation. Let me explain it to you in this way. Jesus said, when we obey His word and His spirit, when we follow Him and His teachings and His love in our life, then we create this strong foundation in our life. And that's the foundation that can help us recover after the devastating storms are over in our life. What we need is a stronger foundation for our mental health and a stronger foundation for our emotional health by having a stronger foundation for our soul. And this is what that strong foundation is. If you're still with me, say, I'm still with you. Notice this today. Loving God and loving people. Matthew chapter 22, verses 36 through 40. Teacher, what's the most important commandment in the law of Moses? Jesus replied, you must love the Lord your God with all of your heart, your soul, all of your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. The second is equally important. Love your neighbor as yourself. The entire law and all the demands of the prophets are based on these two commandments. The entire laws of God, the most important commandments, all of them can be explained with loving God and loving people. If we constantly grow in this and build a strong foundation in our life of loving God and loving people over and over again, then when that day comes, when those devastating storms strike this area of your life or that area of your life, days of pain, you will recover. Your mind, your emotions, and your soul will stand back up again. But not only that, not only will you recover from your days of pain, but you will also have days of peace if you're constantly growing that foundation in your life of loving God more with your heart and loving people. Be prepared, because days of peace are coming too. I understand that when the storm is over, those days will arrive in my life also. Romans 8:28. Notice this today. If you're still with me, say, I'm still with you. And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those that love God and are called according to His purpose for them. The storm is here, but hold on. Don't let go. Don't give up, because days of peace are coming too. Be prepared, because there will come a day when you get to start all over again. Days of peace, when you get to feel love again, when you get to feel purpose again, when you get to feel lovable again. Days of peace, when you get to make new memories again, when you get to get stronger in new areas. Days of peace, hold on. Be prepared, because that day may come when a better opportunity shows up and a better person shows up for you. Days of peace and a better church shows up for you and a better career shows up for you. Days of peace to help you recover. There may come a day when your lover gives you good news and your family gives you good news to help you recover. Days of peace. There may come a day when your doctor gives you better news to help you recover. Days of peace. There may come a day when your children give you good news and the weatherman in Southwest Louisiana finally gives you good news to help you recover. Days of peace. There may come a day when you fall in love again, when you discover a brand new passion that makes you feel alive on the inside. There may come a day when you feel healthy again, strong again, alive again, when you finally feel happy again to help you recover. Days of peace. You've had days of pain, but hold on because you'll have days of peace too. Days of peace that will help you recover from those days of pain. And the only way to be prepared is to make sure that you have a strong foundation. Make sure that your foundation in life of loving God and loving people is thriving and getting stronger. This will not guarantee that your storms will avoid you. This will not guarantee that your storms will not crush you. It just means that one day you will recover once those storms are over. 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 8 through 10. Notice what the missionary says about how life can be devastating. We think you ought to know, dear brothers and sisters, about the trouble we went through in the province of Asia. We were crushed and overwhelmed beyond our ability to endure. And we thought we would never live through it. In fact, we expected to die. As a result, we did not rely on ourselves, but we learned to rely on God who raises the dead. And he rescued us from mortal danger, and he will rescue us again. We have placed our confidence in him, and he will continue to rescue us. I love that last line. We placed our confidence in him. He will continue to rescue us. Sometimes, the text even says it right here, that life is too much. Life will devastate you. Life will crush you. Sometimes your storms just take you past the breaking point. But God has helped you recover before, and his love will help you recover again. You've had days of pain and confusion before. You've had days of loneliness and heartache and doubt before. You've had days of anxiety and exhaustion and depression before. You've had days of anger and giving up before. But hold on, because if your foundation is getting stronger, you will absolutely have days of peace again. Thank you so very much for hanging out with us today. Thank you so very much for tuning in. We hope this helped your heart, and we cannot wait to see you back next week.
What a great message from Pastor Tony. And we really hope today's worship experience has encouraged you and helped you in some way today. And if you're moved by today's service and want to stay tuned the rest of the week on social media, you can check us out at Water's Edge Gathering on Facebook or Water's Edge_LC on Instagram. You can also download our app where you can do online giving, listen to worship songs, and replay messages from Pastor Tony. If you want to learn more about salvation and baptism, want to volunteer, or need a prayer request, you can visit our Welcome Center in the lobby, and our wonderful volunteers will take down your information. We hope you have a great week, and we absolutely love you guys and can't wait to see you back at the Water's Edge, where everyone is welcome.